Welcome back. We're gonna try something new today. Not barbecuing, not plumbing, woodworking. We have no closet doors at this time, so I'm gonna attempt to make my own. We have some doors that are the regular doors that we wanna match, so I couldn't find anything that would fit the opening of our closet door, so I'm gonna go ahead and attempt to make my own. I'll bring you along, we'll see how it goes. These are the doors I'm trying to match. First, we got to start off with some math. So these are our rough openings here. Actually, our finished opening now that I got the closet upstairs done. So we have 45 and 8 width and 81 and a half height. These are the measurements we've come up with. 79 7 eighths is the height. 22 and 5 sixteenths is the width for each panel. If you're like me, you hate fractions. So let's just do it on our tape measure. 81 and a half is our opening. We're going to subtract 1 5/8. So 80 and a half is 1 inch. And we need 5 eighths after that, which is on this tape measure, the little bit bigger lines. 1. 2, 3, 4, and 5, which is 79 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 eighths. So this is what we need to cut these boards to. Now that we got our height, we're going to go ahead and we're going to work on our width, which I showed you earlier is going to be 22 and 5 sixteenths. And since I don't have a track saw, what I'm going to do is mark it out, find how much you need to take off. I'm going to do it on the table saw. Since we're going to be doing the takeoff and we want our board to a certain length and not this side of the blade, instead of measuring to the inside tooth, we're going to measure to the outside tooth. Because you got to take in consideration the width of the blade. So when we measure the 1 5/8 that we need, we're going to be to the outside tooth. Now that we got our 1/2 inch plywood ripped down to size, to get where I want, to kind of give you a vision here, we're gonna rip a 45 on the sides here. We're gonna stack it up, both sides. I got 3 different size boards. I got 1x3s for the sides. I got a 1x6 for the top and a 1x8 for the bottom. So we'll go ahead and get these side pieces cut to size, and then we'll rip the 45 on them. you a good look at the 45 I just put on the board. And as you can see, I'm going to have to miter the other board so it sits flat. At this point, I got everything cut up. You can see here, I'm gluing it down. I only have a few clamps, so I'm gonna do it in stages. So it might take a while, but this is kind of what we're gonna look at here at the end. As you can see, I'm probably gonna have gaps. So I bought wood filler to go back, and it's gonna be painted, so you won't notice it as much. I'll fill in the gaps, go back, sand it, and then prime it, paint it, and it should hide it pretty well. Just put a nice thin layer, spread out all the glue, and then we'll just clamp it down. It's basically what I'm doing for each one, just working in sections. The back side, I have a bunch of knots, because there's only one side. Finished side, so the back I'm not going to see really. So, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go ahead and take some drywall spackle, fill in these larger ones just to kind of give it a smoother finish. After that, I'll go ahead and I will prime it and give us a better idea where we need to go ahead and make adjustments, fill in, sand, all that stuff. Now that I got it sanded, I'm just going to take a microfiber cloth and do a quick wipe down before I prime it. We got it all primed up. From after priming it, it looks pretty good. So I don't think I'm going to sand it again. It's just the back side, so you're not going to see it as much. So I'll let that dry, and we'll move on to the front. I'm going to do the same as I did on the back side, and just go ahead and where some of these knots are, we'll patch it up here. Something like this, because you'll see that. And then we'll primer it and probably do it again. So we're just gonna patch that up, especially something like this. can't see it here, but I made a mark where the middle of the door is going to be. So I'm just lining it up with that and going ahead and mounting it with screws. This one has 4 screws in total. Since we lined that up with 2-inch at the top, this is also going to be 2-inch in the middle. I just double checked it off camera to make sure. So this will go ahead, we'll line up this middle at 2 inches. And then it'll get screwed to the back plate and the ground. The hinges are sitting at 6 inches from the top and the bottom, and then obviously in the center. Alright, so we got it adjusted. Make sure your gap here looks good. I don't have door handles yet, but... The only thing left to do is mount the handles, which I mounted 36 inches off the floor in the middle of the door. And that was it. Hope you enjoyed.